Welcome to John Gets Games. Today, I'll be doing a full three-player playthrough of Manhattan Project Energy Empire. This is a thematic sequel to the original Manhattan Project, and like its predecessor, it is also a worker placement-style engine-building game, but it is quite different from the previous game, and let's just go ahead and jump in, and I'll teach the game as we're actually playing it.
Here we have the starting setup for our three-player game. Each player has a tableau in front of them, and the first thing that every player needs to do is pick which country they're actually going to be representing when they play this game. Now, the main difference between the two countries that you pick is down here, the goods that you spend in order to push yourself up on this United Nations track, which is just a way to get points as you play the game. There is a secondary difference that can be somewhat significant, however, and that is the starting resources that you begin the game with. Now, we see over here that if we were to pick France, as we are playing the red player, we would start with a nuclear energy die, which is really quite great, as well as a science and two money. But if we went with the United States, we'd start with three barrels of oil, a science, and two money. So they're actually pretty similar in everything except for this die and these barrels. And I think, and I'll explain the details of how this works later, we're going to go with France and start with the nuclear die so that we don't have to go out of our way to try and buy one. So this is pretty cool. We can just flip this over, and now we have a handy little turn reference sheet for ourselves. And the other thing that we do is pick one of these two achievements, and this is essentially going to be endgame points for each player. And you can acquire more achievements as you're playing the game, so we're picking between these two, and at a really high level, it's pretty obvious. This one says you get an extra point plus one for every oil rig that you have in your area, and this one gives us a point for every plastic. And I don't think we want to do oil rigs in this game, so we'll pick the plastic one. We put that face down over here, and simultaneously, all the other players do the same. So the blue player decides they are going to be Great Britain, and the green player is going to be India. They've picked these achievements right here, and we're ready to start the game. It's worth noting that each player area has these nice little areas printed on it that show you where to put all these resources, and you can see these five slots for dice. You'll note that you get 2 points at the end of the game for each die that you have, and there is no way to lose dice, to the best of my knowledge, and also this means you can never have more than five of these permanent dice at any one point, so that's a nice little leg up that we have. Energy Empire is a worker placement style game, and we start with three of these workers here, but we also start with two energy, which can sometimes act as a worker as well. I'll explain how energy works as we need it, but let's go ahead into the first turn, and on your turn, you either place a worker out onto the board and evaluate actions, or you generate, and generate essentially means recall back all of your workers and make some more energy. So we obviously don't want to generate anything yet. I think we're going to want to send a worker out, and to start, well, first of all, you always put a single worker down when you do an action. And the worker can be placed anywhere on the board with this little worker symbol here. I think right off the bat, we want to go over to this government market over here in order to buy one of these government buildings. There are three different sections to the board. We have government, we have industry, and commerce. And you'll notice that these worker placement spots are all associated with each of these three colors out on the board. Energy Empire is also an engine building game, and these buildings are really the way you put your engine together. And we know that we are playing as France, and one big way to get points is to go up on the United Nations track. For us, it's going to cost science and money in order to do that, so I think it's a good idea for us to start right off the bat trying to make ways for us to make more science. So let's go ahead and buy this nuclear agency right here, and we see that it's going to cost us either two money or one science symbol. So I think maybe, considering this building actually makes science symbols, let's go ahead and spend this one in order to purchase this building. And whenever a building is taken from the market, you slide down the remaining buildings and refill from the top of the deck for the other side. There's one more thing we have to evaluate on this building before we can take it, and that is the type of contamination that this building brings us. This is the nuclear agency, and unfortunately that means it brings nuclear contamination into our atmosphere. Now, we always take contamination from these stacks over here. These each have five pollution in them because this is a three-player game, so we're going to take the top one from the stack, and we're actually going to flip it over to show that it's now nuclear, and nuclear is essentially twice as bad as these regular pollutions over here, and I think it's worth mentioning now that this is also the game clock. Once all of these pollution have been pulled off of this area, the game will end, and each time we get through a single one of these stacks, not only is the price for oil going to increase, but we're going to flip over one of these global impact cards, and the green ones are nice. They'll give us potential benefits for the first half of the game, and then the second half of the game, mean stuff is going to happen. So we get to put the nuclear agency into our area, but we now have to apply this nuclear contamination. And you'll notice that we begin the game with one regular contamination in our atmosphere. Every single player does. So our atmosphere is really not looking great. We can put this on any of these spots here, but I think for now we want to go over here. It'll become obvious why there's some potential endgame scoring over here. So there's no reason really not to go in the leftmost spot. As a second phase of a working turn, once you put a worker out onto the main board, you can then activate as many buildings that you own of that specific type, according to where you put the worker down. So we put a worker down into the government area. We bought this government card. we can now activate all government buildings. So let's go ahead and do that for our nuclear agency here. And we see it takes a worker and a worker, or an energy and an energy, or a worker and an energy. Any mix and match of these two different types of resources will activate this and get us a metal and a science. So let's use a worker and an energy. And there's a pretty good reason for using the worker. That has to do with trying to go onto spots that opponents have already jumped on by saving this energy here. I'll explain more about how that works, I think, on our next turn. It's very likely that we'll need to do that. So this means we get our metal and we get our science. And we also have an interesting opportunity. We could go over here with this energy or this worker in order to spend the science and the two money we already have to go up once on the United Nations track. But we're going to need, I think, this energy in order to go onto a spot that we want to. So we'll hold off for now. This doesn't increase our engine at all. It's just endgame victory points. It is good to be in the lead on this track, but we'll get to it soon, I think. It's now the blue player's turn, and they are going to go down to the power plant. You'll notice that for the government and commerce area, there are only four worker placement spots, but for industry, there is this fifth one down here, which allows you to build more dice. There are five different colored dice in the game, but only four of them can actually be purchased to put on your player mat. We've got the green, blue, black, and yellow. And the blue player right now only has the resources in order to buy this hydro geo die here. And the reason you want to get dice is because, well, they're going to increase the amount of energy you get when you do a generate action. And right now the blue player has no dice at all. They didn't start with any. So they're going to grab this one. It's important to note that you can have a maximum of one of these blue dice as opposed to the others, which you can have any number of them if you like. And in addition to spending one of the two metal they start the game with, they're going to have to take a pollution and put it into their land area. Each person's player board comes with a handy-dandy chart that shows you the outcome for all six sides of each of the five different types of the dice. You'll see that the 2, 3, 4, 5 segments for each of the dice are identical, so you get a good idea of what's on these dice and what you might want or not want. So they get their hydro geo die, and they're going to take this pollution from the top of the stack right here, and they're going to go ahead and put it down right into that land spot there and put this onto their board. They can now activate any industry buildings they have in front of them, except that they don't actually have any buildings. So they're not done with their turn, and we go to the green player. It's worth noting that the green player chose India as their country, and as part of their starting bonus, they get to start with a fourth worker. You can have up to six workers in your area, and there are a couple different ways to acquire new ones, but India gets a leg up there, but gets very little in the way of other resources. So they're going to start by placing this worker out. They're going to go to the commerce market, and they're going to pick up this import company. It's actually really good for them. We immediately slide this over and bring out a new card, and India is going to have to take a contamination into their water. So the contamination will go down here, and the reason this card is so good for them is because we see that this import company lets them spend $1 to get a barrel of oil and get a plastic, and it only costs a worker or an energy, just one. And the United Nations bump over here is a barrel of oil and a plastic, so this synergizes really well for a relatively cheap, I mean one money, they can get what they need to make that bump. And money can be somewhat tight. In fact, right now, the green player has zero money, so they can't actually activate this card, but they're sure they'll be going back to the commerce area on future turns in order to grab this when they actually have the cash. So it's our turn again, and we really do want to pick up a new power plant, but we noticed the blue player went here already, so what we have to do is put down energy so that we have a higher stack than our opponent. These are nice, chunky cardboard components, so you'll see that we are now higher, so we can now evaluate this spot. So it costs us an extra resource. Energy is nice in order to activate buildings and whatnot, but it's more important for us to get over here and spend this one metal in order to grab a hydro geo die of our own. This brings us up to two dice, which is nice because we're out of workers and we'll be forced to generate on our next turn, but we also need to take one pollution from the global impact track. And it's worth noting, there's only a single pollution left, so we are going to be getting into these impacts really rather soon. So we would take this and we have to put it down into the land area, so I'll just put it right there. We activated the industry section, but have no industry cards to actually grab with our second part. Plus, we actually have no energy or worker, so our turn is done, and we go over to blue. Blue decides to go to the industry market, and they're going to pick up a uranium mine, which, interestingly enough, is essentially the industry version of the nuclear agency that we got. It has the same cost requirements and the same benefits. It looks pretty good for them, and it's also going to put a nuclear token down as contamination, but this one's going to go on the land for them as opposed to the air for us. We refill the cargo and see what's next. And of course, blue spends a metal in order to buy that actual building there. The uranium mine goes into blue's area and they take their contamination, which is going to be nuclear. They have to put it into a land area. And you'll notice this was the last token for this global impact track over here. We're not going to actually evaluate this card until the end of the blue player's turn. So they're going to go ahead and put this down and they figure, well, they'll just cover up this land right there. They are going to evaluate this over here as well, and they've decided, they're going to spend both of these here in order to take a science and a metal from the supply. And then they're going to spend their last energy here to actually activate their United Nations ability. We see that this costs them the metal they just grabbed, as well as the two money that they started the game with. So these are going to go away, but their token over here on the track is going to get pushed up once. This track is pretty straightforward. We see they've essentially made themselves 4 victory points at the end of the game, and with each tick, they're going to get more points, although the difference between the jumps gets less and less as you get farther along. However, once somebody gets to the 17th spot, they're the only ones that can go on there, and there's a bonus of 3 points for the person in the lead. So the blue player is essentially trying to get ahead, and then they'll probably try to stay one step ahead of the bus for the rest of the game, but it does cost them that precious money that they have right now, which could allow them to buy a new building. And now let's look at our first Global Impact card. There are 3 different aspects to each of these cards. We see that this one is called Cheap Imports, and each player is going to get 1 point for each uncovered water space on their board. We're also going to recycle all of the economy buildings and get 3 fresh new ones. And down here we have an event. It says that we immediately place 1 plastic onto each commerce board location. First things first, let's go ahead and get rid of all of these cards here and see 3 new ones. And oh wow, right off the bat, that bank is great. See this? 1 worker lets you get 2 money, and you can evaluate this one 2 separate times. So you can spend 2 workers to get 4 money. That's actually a pretty amazing building right there. So now we're going to put plastics down on all 4 of these zones. And what this means is this is an extra incentive for placing into these worker placement spots. The first person to do each of these is going to get a bonus plastic for their efforts. And we can't forget to score our points for water. So that means that we actually get 5 points. The blue player gets 5 points, but unfortunately the green player has 1 contamination down here, so they're only going to get 4. It's not much, but it means we are still tied for the lead. It's now the green player's turn, and they actually want to evaluate this commerce market a second time. So once again, they have to make a stack bigger than the previous one, even though the previous one was their own color. So they're going to put down a single energy in order to go here, and they're going to buy this bank. They're going to spend the 1 plastic they have on their player sheet in order to grab it, and as a bonus, they get this plastic from the board for going there first. We can go ahead and refresh to see a new card, and oh, that's nice. 1 worker to get 3 money, but everybody else is going to get 1. I'd like to point out another nice thing about the bank is it has no contamination on it. Also, I forgot to mention that every single one of these buildings has a star value on it. These are endgame victory points. So they're going to put the bank down here, and now they can evaluate all of their commerce buildings. So the first thing they're going to do is take 1 of their workers, and they're going to put it down here and get 2 money. So I actually misspoke earlier. You can only evaluate this 1 at a time. So on another commerce step in the future, I could evaluate the second one, but you can't do both of them in the same evaluation. But this is still great to spend 1 worker in order to get 2 money. And then they're going to spend 1 of these money and this energy here in order to activate their import company in order to grab a plastic and a barrel of oil. And after thinking about it for a bit, they've decided not to activate their United Nations ability. They do have the stuff for it, but they have no energy dice at this point. They figure they're probably going to have to use these barrels of oil to get those petroleum dice, which I haven't really explained yet. I will very soon. So for now, they're not going to do that. They're going to leave this person, and they'll figure out what they're going to do on the next turn when they get over there. It's back to us, and we have no workers, so we're forced to do the first generate action of the game. The first thing that you do is look to see if you have a combination of 2 energy or workers, and if you do, then you can essentially spend them to get new achievement tiles, but we are out of everything. So the second thing we do is retrieve all of our workers back to our player board and then discard all of the energy we have left. If we, in fact, had energy down here after potentially discarding for the achievement, we still don't get to keep it from round to round, so this goes away. And now what we're going to do is figure out if we want to roll additional dice. Well, actually, it's easy for us. We could throw away up to 5 petroleum or oil barrels in order to grab 5 of these petroleum dice. But I just realized we have no oil. So these are the dice we get to use. So we are now going to roll them. And it's important to note that you don't have to roll all of your dice. You can pick and choose because some of these dice can give you contamination. But we got really lucky. The thing that you do is you look to see which die has the highest number. And we see that this blue die has a 5, and the yellow nuclear die has a 3. The higher one is the one that evaluates. And since the blue die has no contamination on it at all, that means we are not going to take any. If this yellow die had been higher than the blue die, we would have been forced to put down another nuclear contamination onto our area, which would be pretty bad, and it's one of the reasons I got this die, so that we can kind of dilute the terrible nature of this nuclear die. However, the nuclear die is great at making energy. So we now add up all of the little energy symbols. We see we have 5. We're going to have 5 energy for the next cycle, so we can go ahead and grab all of that. And we must always remove one contamination from these tracks whenever a generation happens. So if I had rolled worse, this would have come down into our area, but since that Hydro Geo die was awesome for us, we just discard this from the game and it keeps the game clock going. The blue player is also out of workers, so they're forced to do a generation. They have nothing to discard for achievements, so they're going to take all of their workers back, discard their energy, and they now decide they're going to spend one of these barrels of oil back to the bank in order to grab one of these petroleum dice. They are pretty darn good. They're almost as good as the nuclear dice, but they only give you regular contamination as opposed to nuclear. And the blue player is going to roll both of these, and ooh, looks like they got lucky too. Well, sort of lucky. The high-value die is the one that is going to help them with contamination, so they don't take any. But this petroleum die did very poorly. It only has a 1 in 6 chance to only give 1 energy, so unfortunately, the blue player is only going to get 3 energy for this next round. And of course, we then pull one from the top here and throw it away. It now goes to the green player, who could generate this turn if they wanted to. You don't have to wait until you're out of workers, but they decided they want to spend their worker doing one more thing. For the third time in a row, they're going to head over to the commerce area, and they want to take more advantage of these free plastics that are just floating around. So they can go here, and they can now buy or sell oil once. So you can spend whatever the price of oil is right now for 3 barrels, or get rid of 3 barrels in order to get that much money. We can see that the current price is $1 for 3 barrels, so they'll get rid of the $1 that they had. And now they have 5 barrels of oil. So you can bet if they had one more energy, they would for sure hit this United Nations now, considering that's pretty much all they have in their area. But they are out of people, so unfortunately they can't take use of that. It's now our turn, and we can see with this 5 energy, we have potentially a lot more we can do with our turn. And we're certainly going to use this energy more for activating our buildings than we had prior. So I think the first thing that we should do is actually buy yet another government building. It'll let us activate this as well. And we'll spend the 1 science in order to grab this work core here. It is going to give us a pollution on our land area, but we can then spend just a single energy or person in order to clean up some contamination in our player mat, or spend 4 money in order to get a new worker. The card row cycles, and now we have a materials research spot. Okay, that is exactly the same as this one over here. Some of the cards have multiple versions in the deck. I believe that's what these 2 little ticks down here means. There are 2 of this type of card in the deck. So we now have the work core, and we of course take a pollution from the top here. We have to put it in our land area. We'll go ahead and plunk it right there. And we only have $2, so we can't actually hire a new person. But one of the reasons we grab this one is because it's relatively cheap in order to remove contamination. Of course, we took some by actually getting this card here. So I think right from the get-go, let's just go ahead and move the contamination that we just put down off of our board by activating that with a single energy. And then we're going to take, I think, 2 more energy and activate our nuclear agency over here because it's also a government building. This gives us 1 steel and 1 science, and with that, our turn is over. The blue player decides to go to the finance area in the commerce section. They largely are doing this to grab the free plastic, but they're also just going to evaluate this spot here to give themselves 2 money. They could get 3 or 4 money, but that would give 1 or 2 bucks to each other player. And right now, they like having everybody else not have money as well. So they're just going to get the plastic and 2 bucks. And since they have no commerce buildings to evaluate, their turn is over. Green has no workers, so they must generate. So they'll pull all of their workers back to their board, discard the energy that they had, and now they've decided they're going to spend 3 of their oil barrels here in order to roll 3 of these temporary pollution dice. They're guaranteed to take 1 pollution, but they figure they need energy to supplement all of their workers. And they did okay here. They got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 energy. That's pretty good, and 1 contamination down. They can put this anywhere on their board that's currently open, and they figure they'll just go nice and even and put it down into the land. And now with this 6 energy and 4 workers, they're pretty set up for a very good next phase of the game for themselves. It's our turn again, and I think it's time for us to diversify our buildings. We're going to go to the industry market, and we're going to grab this one right here. We're going to spend the 2 money in order to grab this one. We could have spent the 1 steel we have instead, but you'll note that this allows us to spend a steel in order to get 2 plastic. And if you remember, we started with this achievement in front of us that will give us 1 point for each plastic we have in front of us at the end of the game. Now, every achievement can't score you more than 5 points, so it's essentially up to 5 plastic in front of us. But this is a really nice card for turning steel into plastic, and we don't terribly care about having steel around, so using it to make a couple plastic is a pretty good ratio. Also, this has no contamination on it. We refill the row and see the next card. It is a modernized factory. This is cool. It allows you to spend 1 worker or energy in order to get a steel or a plastic. Let's go ahead and activate the supply chain immediately. So we'll use just 1 energy. We'll get rid of this steel here, and we'll generate two plastics for ourselves, and with that, our turn is over. Blue decides they want to grab a Commerce Market card. They happen to have one plastic, and they're going to use it in order to grab this resort here. We see that what the card says is you gain one money for each of your unpolluted airspaces in your environment. It does cost two people, but right now the blue player has an almost contamination-free environment, so they're going to get four money for these two placements down here. They feel pretty good about that. They're probably going to try to clean this one out before they activate this one again in the future just to get the maximum amount of five money from it. And luckily for them, this building does not come with any contamination. And of course, we have to reset the commerce buildings. This new one is very simple. It's a warehouse. It just generates a plastic. The green player decides to go over here to the trade section of the commerce spot. They're going to grab the last of these free plastics right here, and they can now trade unlimitedly two money for a steel or a plastic, and same with their science symbols. This brings them up to four plastic, and they decide to liquidate some of these assets. They're going to get rid of three of these in order to get six money from the bank, and then they're going to immediately turn the six money into four money in order to grab one steel from the market. So that goes right over here. Now they'll start activating their buildings. They'll go here and spend $1 in order to gain a plastic and an oil barrel. And then they're going to spend this energy over here in order to immediately spend those two resources in order to go once up on the United Nations track. And why not? They'll go here and grab two more money for placing that last energy there. This means that they're tied with the blue player. It's once again our turn, and we have one worker and one energy left over. I think that since we're really close to generating again, I think we want to get another die, especially to dilute the potential terrible power of this yellow die. We got lucky on the first roll, but we want to make ourselves in a position to have us not taking these nuclear contaminations. So, considering we have a plastic and a science out here, let's go ahead and grab ourselves a green solar wind die. We see that they are not a very interesting die. There's lots of ones on them, but they have no contamination, so this will just help dilute that nuclear power die that we have already kicking for us. And it's, of course, worth two extra points to us at the end of the game, so not too shabby all around. Blue decides to spend a worker and an energy in order to go into this government market, and they're going to buy this other work core card with the one science that they currently have. This is going to give them one land contamination, of course. And we refill the card row. We see that we now have a space program. This is pretty cool. You can spend one science in order to get a victory point, get a steel or a plastic, and this last symbol here, which I haven't actually explained, this just lets you look at any of the face-down global impact cards so you can get a good idea of what's coming as well as which of the environments it's going to score so that you can prepare for it. Speaking of which, when they build this corp card down, they actually pull the last pollution from there. This goes into their forest area, and they've not finished their turn. Unfortunately, they don't have any energy left. That really bad die roll, man, if they just rolled one more energy, they could have executed this and have been really nice for them, but they still like the looks of this card, so let's go ahead and finish their turn and move on to the global impact. The second one says a oil boom, so it's going to score for the land for each player. We're going to recycle the government cards, and down here it says that immediately, starting in player order with the current active player, each person can do a drill mine action, so for free, essentially. Let's start by wiping out the government cards and seeing three new ones. We've got a national park. We've also got a nuclear reactor, and then finally a canal. The national park is much like that resort, except it scores money for the land areas. This nuclear reactor, wow, that just gives you two science and a peak. That's pretty awesome. And 5 points. Of course, you have to put nuclear pollution down, which is not great. And then finally over here, the canal, it's pretty simple and quite good, actually. You get two money or a steal when you put a worker down there. Now we each score for our land areas, so we're going to get four victory points. The blue player, unfortunately, is only going to get two victory points, and then green will also get four. This brings us to 9, blue to 7, and then green up to 8. Blue is the active player, so they're the first to figure out if they want to do a oil drill action. And this is pretty simple. All you do is take one of these little tokens and you put it down for the land side or the water side if you want to drill on the land or the water. Now, blue decides they do actually want to drill, but there are only four different spots on each player board with these little oil drops that can take these spots. Since they've plugged up all of their land, they must drill in the water, so they'll go right here and immediately they'll generate a one-time 3 barrels of oil, and for the rest of this game, this spot is effectively blocked. They won't score points for it, and it will unfortunately never actually make them oil again. Green decides they would like to get some more oil, so they'll put this down here. They'll go on the land, and they'll take 3 more barrels of oil. As you can see, they have no dice at the moment, so they figure they'll need these barrels in order to roll some dice and keep their energy engine going. And even though we have a couple different spots to put this oil rig down, I think we're pretty happy with our current energy generation ability, so let's just not do that and keep our spaces clear. Green decides to head over to the power plant. They'll spend one energy in order to go here, since we already have a person here, and they're going to grab their first official die. They're going to spend this one steel from their supply, and they decided, yeah, they'll go ahead and grab a Hydro Geo die as well. You can have a maximum of one. It will give them one pollution, but in the future, it might help dilute the all those petroleum dice that they are currently rolling. And the pollution goes down on land. Maybe they are regretting putting their oil rig right here, but we'll see how it pans out. And now we see they have no industrial buildings to activate, so their turn is done. It's our turn once again, and we have no workers. Unfortunately, just one energy left over. We would need two energy in order to grab a new achievement. So this is just going to be wasted, unfortunately, but we can now go ahead and consolidate everything by getting rid of all of the energy in front of us and pulling back our workers. We have no barrels of oil, so we can't roll any petroleum dice. So we'll just go ahead and roll these three right here. And oh, looks like we got pretty lucky again. The nuclear die is rolling nice and low for us. So we get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 energy for this next set of turns. And of course, we have to discard the top contamination over here. Doesn't go onto our board because we rolled well, but it still gets removed to keep the clock going. It's Blue's turn, and they must also generate. So they're going to go ahead and discard all of this stuff. They now have, well, still have just one Hydro Geo die here. So they've decided they are going to spend two of these petroleum, oil barrels in order to get two petroleum dice. They did one the last time and really felt burned by the lack of energy around. It does mean that they're likely to take more pollution, but they really need energy in order to keep their stuff going. So they'll go ahead and roll those dice. And oh, this is interesting. So whenever you have a tie for the highest value die, you actually get to choose the one you want. So Blue is somewhat lucky here. They choose this one right here. They don't have to put any contamination down, and they're going to get 6 energy for the next set of turns. So that worked out pretty well for them. And we go ahead and remove the top pollution from the stack. The green player is still going hard on the commerce buildings, and they decide to once again go over here. They're going to spend 2 of their money, and they're going to go ahead and grab this airport here. We see it's going to contaminate their air, so they take one from the top of the stack, and there's only one more left to the third stack of the game, so we're really close to the halfway point. So they go ahead and put that up there, and now they can evaluate over here. They are just going to go here, and they're going to go here, because once again, this can be evaluated twice just on separate activations. They're going to get 2 money, and they're going to sell a barrel of oil for 2 more money and a victory point. So that's 4 money total. They're now tied for the lead at 9. And let's see some more commerce cards. This one is going to be, oh, it's a farm. 2 people to get 2 bucks and 1 victory point. It's our turn, and we've got a lot of good things going for us. We've got a whole bunch of energy. We've got some really good buildings, but a couple things we haven't done yet. We haven't bumped our United Nations track at all, which is something we want to keep in mind. But more importantly, we are pretty much tapped out on resources. We just have this one plastic, and we really need to get money. We're going to need money if we want to use this to get more workers, and we're just going to need money in order to push up that track. So I think with that in mind, let's put a worker with an energy over here into the commerce section, and then spend the one plastic that we have in order to grab this stock market here. It has no contamination, but it'll let us get 3 money for activating it once, but we are going to give money to our opponents, unfortunately. And let's see what the next card from the top is. It is a mass transit system. Oh, it's pretty simple, just 1 money and a victory point for 1 activation. That seems pretty good. Another nice thing about having a building from all 3 sets on the board is that we are incentivized to go pretty much anywhere after generations. We're never going to be doing an action on the board, at least early on, and then feel like we don't get any benefit from it. So let's go ahead and throw this down here. We're going to get 3 money from the bank. And both of our opponents get 1, but they already had lots of money, so that probably isn't going to affect their decisions too much. Now we go to the blue player, who is fresh off of a generation with a whole bunch of energy, quite a bit of money at 7, and a couple barrels of oil. They decided that they are going to do a new action on the board. They want to educate. They're going to spend 3 money in order to do this, and they're going to gain a new worker, but they do need to take a pollution out from the stack and put it onto the board. This is the last pollution from the stack, so we're going to go ahead and do another global impact at the end of their turn. That's interesting. That's happened a couple times at the end of their turn, and they have decided to put this down onto their water section. They gain a new worker from the supply, and they're now going to spend 1 of their energy, and they're going to put it over here on a work core, and they decided, you know, maybe a little crazy, but they're going to spend all 4 of their remaining money, and they're going to recruit once again. So it's a little more expensive, but they don't put any pollution down. So that means on this turn, they've almost doubled their overall workforce. They now have 5 workers that they're playing with. With that, their turn is over, so let's go ahead and evaluate that global impact. You can see that we've reached the halfway point in the game. This is the last nice impact that's going to happen. The rest of them are going to have mean things that are going to kind of get in our way. This is civil rights. We're going to score points for our air pollution, and we're going to recycle the government cards. And down here, we see that immediately in player order, each player gets to decide if they want to take a new worker or 5 victory points immediately. Let's score the air first. We get 3 points, blue gets 4 points, and green is going to get 3 points. So both of us go to 12 points, and then blue goes all the way up to 11. The government market once again gets recycled. And let's see the new buildings. We've got an enrichment facility. Ooh, it's pretty mean. It's going to give you a nuclear contamination, but it lets you trade a steel for a science at a point. That's pretty good. And it is worth 5 points at the end of the game, which is quite a lot. Now we have an environmental agency. This one's pretty cool. You spend 2 money in order to clean up one thing from your area and then also gain a science. So that also no contamination. Cool card. And then the lunar lander. No contamination, just get a science or a point. Definitely some neat options here. Now each player in order gets to decide if they want a new worker or 5 victory points. And the blue player, they just got 2 new workers on that turn, but they are a little crazy, and they decide, you know what, they're going to go all the way up to their 6th worker. They have no more workers they could grab. They're capped out, and I think, you know, these workers can be used, are very similar to energy, so they have very few of these dice that they're using, so they're kind of supplementing the fact that their energy rolls might be slightly lower with just this constant workforce here, although that did cost them 5 points. The green player started out with 4 workers, and they decided they'll take a 5th one as well, probably for the similar reason of just having a small dice engine resource area right now. And now it comes to us. We currently only have 3 workers, and going up to 4 right now would be quite nice. However, we do have this work core over here, and it allows us to spend 4 money to get new workers, and we're also rolling quite a bit of energy every single time we do a generation. I think maybe let's try to take those 5 victory points and just jump a little bit ahead of our opponents. That's a pretty real amount of points in the game. This might be a mistake, but I think that getting a little bit of an edge over there might be good for us going forward. We were at 12, now we jump all the way up to 17. This feels a bit risky, but I'm curious to see how it pans out for us. It's now the green player's turn, and since they have no energy, they don't actually have the ability to put their workers down on any spots on the board that already have anybody's workers. They could stop right now and generate, and with these 2 workers, they could grab a new achievement for this pile. You can have at most 5 achievements in one game, but I think they have a better plan for this guy right here. They really like the looks of this environmental agency card right here. That's going to cost them 3 money, but they're totally fine with that. They give this up, and they still have 5 left over. So they'll go ahead and grab this card. It doesn't have any contamination on it. We'll refresh the row and see that we now have a Space Academy as an option. Oh, this is cool. That's another way to hire workers, this time just spending science instead of money. So this gets added into their area, and they're going to use their last worker here in order to activate this. They're going to spend the 2 money, and they get 1 science and 1 of these recycling symbols. Now, again, the way these work is you can either remove a regular pollution from anywhere on your board, or you could flip a nuclear over to the regular pollution side. So the green player, they just get to remove 1 of these. I think they're going to take this one off of the board. It frees up that spot in case land happens to score again, and they want to free this up as well, because at the end of the game, each one of these columns is going to score points along the top if they are open. So it just makes a lot of sense to try and keep all the pollution on the left-hand side of your board. It's our turn once again, and while we do have a little bit of money now, we still have very little resources, but I think we want to go to a government agency in order to run these things over here and potentially go ahead and do our United Nations for the first time. So let's go ahead and take our worker. First of all, we look to the buildings up here, and this one doesn't really interest us. This one would be really nice. It gives us a science or a victory point for a very cheap activation and no contamination. And this one over here, it's another way to potentially hire new people, this time without actually spending money. And money is definitely our downfall at the moment. But the problem is, if we go here, we have to buy one of these buildings with money, because we don't have any science symbols at the moment. So I think what we should actually do is go down here. It doesn't cost us any extra energy, which is nice. We'll get a science symbol from this, and we get to peek at one of those global impact cards. Since we're 6 contamination away from the next reveal, let's go ahead and look at the closest one, so we can take a look and see that this is actually going to score for the forest area, which is pretty good news for us, because we only have 1 contamination there already. But then down here, we see that it says, until another global impact card is triggered, players must use 1 additional energy to place a worker on any board location that is occupied by 1 or more workers belonging to other players. So for a whole round of, you know, the next stack going away, it'll be much harder to go onto spots that other people are at. Well, that's good to know, but not necessarily something that we can plan for. So we'll mostly just keep this in mind, knowing that it'd be great to clear out that last 4 spot to get more points. The worker placement spot gets us our first science token, and then I think let's go ahead and spend the 2 energy over here to activate the nuclear agency, and that'll get us a steel and another science token. So we're finally starting to have some resources we can play with here. Now, I think it does make sense. We're going to go over here and activate the work core. We only have 3 money, so we can't get another worker, but we can, for free, recycle one of the contamination in our area. And I think we definitely want to take this off because we know that this is going to be the row that scores next time. So that's effectively worth a victory point for us, at least one, at this point in the game. And now, I think, let's go ahead and do our first United Nations hit. This is going to cost us one of our 2 signs, so we still have signs remaining. And it will cost us 2 out of the 3 money we have, which isn't great because we've been having these money problems, but it is important to go up that track and not fall too far behind. And also, we have these resources which can be converted into buildings, for instance, and we'll be able to specifically use the money for the things that we really want to, like the United Nations. So let's go ahead and give this a bump now. Our opponents did it much earlier than us, but it seems like they stalled out, and we're now all tied again at the first step. It's now the blue player's turn with their massive contingent of workers. They already have one out on the board, in fact. They're just going to take one of them and activate the finance spot for only 2 money. And since they activated economy, they've decided they are going to do this resort as well. And they're going to do 1 worker and 1 energy, kind of hedging their bets. It's nice to have one and the other because with the if you use all energy and just have a bunch of workers, then you obviously won't be able to go onto any spots on the board that opponents are at. So it's good to have energy in your store, but also, of course, you need workers to actually activate events. So they'll go here, they'll get 1 money for each of their clear air spots. That's still only 4. Maybe they should have, instead of spending that money, cleared that spot over there so they get more money from that spot. But yeah, that's the way we're playing it, so they get 4 more bucks. And with that, their turn is over. Green has no workers, so they have to generate. So they get their 5 workers back to the board. All of this energy, it gets discarded. And they decide to spend 2 out of their 4 oil barrels in order to get 2 petroleum dice to roll with their blue one. Let's see if they get as lucky this time. And nope, this time it definitely didn't. Although they do have quite a bit of energy to play with again. So that's 6 energy, but with these petroleum dice at 4, they're going to have to put down 1 contamination. They decide to keep things nice and even, going down there in the water, and they're going to grab their 6 energy. It's back to us, and we have this 1 measly worker with no energy to back them up. And while there are several spots out on the board I could put this down and do something, there's no real kick to that turn. Like, we won't be able to activate any buildings from behind, and all those spots out there don't seem particularly great for us. So I think let's just go ahead and generate. It's unfortunate we don't have 1 more worker or energy in order to get an achievement right now. Definitely thinking I probably should not have taken those victory points, but let's go ahead and pull everybody back, discard all of this energy. And then we can roll our 3 dice right here. We, again, have no oil to actually spend. And it looks like we had our best roll yet, actually. We're going to get 7 energy, which is great. And the green is still the highest number, so we don't put any contamination down. So all these come back, in addition to a new one. And this is, I think, the most energy anyone's had at any point in this game so far. It's worth noting that you can never have more than 10 energy at one point in time, so we're already doing pretty well going towards that cap. And of course, we discard this contamination. There are only 3 left in this stack. The blue player is going to start their turn by going to the industry market, and they're going to grab this small steel mill here. It's a pretty simple card, no contamination, and it's going to cost them 3 money because they don't currently have any steel. And let's see what the new building option is. It's a small plastics factory. Oh, very similar to the steel one we just grabbed. They had 6 bucks, so now they only have 3. And they can go ahead and activate both of these buildings if they want, and I believe that they are going to do just that. So 1 energy is going to go here in order to grab 1 steel from the supply, and then they're going to spend, I think, these 2 energy here to grab another steel and a science. Now they're going to send 1 of their people over to the United Nations spot. They're going to spend 2 money, bringing them down to 1, and 1 of these steel in order to bump their token again, which once again puts them into the lead. It now comes to Green, who has a ton of stuff available to them. They got 5 workers, 6 energy, 3 money, and some oil. So they're going to start off seemingly simple by putting a single worker out on the board. And they'll activate the trade location where they can spend 2 money for a steel or a plastic or a science, vice versa, as many times as they want to. They'll start by turning this plastic into a science token, and then they're going to spend 2 money into a steel. Now they're going to start activating some of their buildings. They're going to begin by going here, and they're going to spend their last current dollar in order to grab a barrel of oil and plastic. Next, they'll activate their airport with 1 energy, giving rid of this 1 barrel of oil in order to get 2 money and a victory point, which brings them to 13. Now they'll send one of their workers to the bank. This gets them 2 money, and they'll put an energy into the United Nations. They'll spend their plastic and a barrel of oil in order to bump their token. So once again, we are in last place on that track. We're coming off the back of a very productive generate cycle. I think the thing that we really need is money. We just really need money. So let's go ahead and take one of our only three workers and one of our seven energy. We'll activate finance, but once again, just do it for the $2 and not give our opponents any money. And then let's send one of our energies over to the stock market, which is going to get us three more money, but unfortunately we'll give both of our opponents one. So we are sitting happily at six money, while blue player has two and the green player has five. We do have the means to hit our United Nations button again, but I think we may as well hold off for the moment, see what our other options are, because we can always chain into this one from any worker placement spot. It's now the blue player's turn, and they have one energy and one worker, but they have decided they are actually pretty happy. They're going to generate, so before they grab anything, since they have at least two of these left over, they can grab a new achievement for their pile. They honestly don't love any of these options, but they'll grab this energy reserves here, which will get them up to 5 points for each energy they have on hand when the game ends. And as soon as we grab this, we're going to see a new achievement from the top of the stack. Ah, this one just gets you 1 point for every two money you have. Normally, money is just part of a tiebreaker. This gets added into their stack, and now they can recall all of their six workers from the various parts of the board into their area and discard all of their energy. It's now time for them to roll dice. They have their one hydro electro die here. They really need to think about getting some new dice. That's costing them a lot to ditch these oil barrels every time, but I think once again they're going to get rid of both of these here in order to get two petroleum dice. And with all three of these, they get pretty lucky. They got a six on the... Oh, wow. This is a great roll for them, actually. That's going to get them seven energy, and they don't put any contamination down. We, of course, remove one contamination from the stack, leaving two remaining. We now go to the green player, who sees a great opportunity. They're going to go to this power plant and pick up themselves one of these coal dice. They're going to get rid of this steel in order to do that. So they permanently have this. It's their second die, and it's nice just to go in here and grab it while they don't have to spend the extra energy. They put this over here, showing that that's going to be two extra points to them at the end of the game, and that's probably good considering their large oil collection has been slowly dwindling as they've been generating turn over after turn. It comes back to us, and let's use our second worker in order to activate a government building. The government market is rather clear, and this building is pretty cheap, so let's go ahead and grab this lunar lander here. It's got some nice options. It gives us a science or a victory point every time we activate it. It gives us no contamination, which is really nice for us, and we happen to have the science in order to be able to afford it right now. We slide this over and see what the next card is, and it is a science lab. So twice you can get a science and look at global impact cards. This would be much more important, I think, early in the game, where you could repeatedly get to peek and potentially know really every single event before they actually happen for you. So we add that lunar lander over here, and now we can do a whole bunch of stuff with the energy we have. Let's go ahead and begin by going right here. That'll get us a steel and a science from the supply. Next up, let's activate the work core. And, you know, our pollution situation is pretty wrapped up at the moment. I think let's go ahead and spend the four money in order to recruit our first new person of the game. So we now are up to four workers, which is really quite nice. And I think there's really no reason not to go over here. And let's see. Actually, before we do that, let's go over here. We're going to spend our two money and this one science in order to bump the United Nations track. This means we're all once again tied. It's funny, we were all kind of ignoring it, but now that our engines are doing much better, we can start squeezing these in. I wonder if at some point someone will break into the lead. And finally, I think we should go ahead and activate this lunar lander over here, and let's go ahead and grab a science. Victory points are nice to have, but we're currently in the lead on that, and we have no science, and it's just good to have different resources to give ourselves increased options out on the board, especially if we want to buy more buildings, for instance. So we are going to end our turn there. We have these two people here, which means for our next turn, we're probably going to be generating so that we can grab a new achievement, but we will evaluate that when it becomes our turn next time.
So now we go to Blue, who has six workers and seven energy, so just a ton of different options for them, but they're just going to send a single worker and a single energy out because they've decided to activate this power plant. They've gone too long on just the hydroelectro die, and they're going to spend a steel and a science in order to get a nuclear die from the stack. So this is definitely the most energy that they can grab, but it has the threat of taking more nuclear contamination. And since they activated an industrial spot, they're going to now go into these two buildings here. They'll spend an energy in the small steel mill in order to get themselves one steel, and they figure they'll do an energy and one of their many workers to go here. That'll get them at this uranium mine one more steel as well as a science. They've decided they are going to spend, let's see, that four and four. They'll do one energy over here to Great Britain. They'll use one of these steel, and that will get rid of these two money, and now they get to go up one more time on the United Nations track. This is a 4 victory point bump for them, and it puts them in the lead once again. It's now Green's go, and they decide to go to the cleanup spot. This lets them spend one of their 2 science tokens in order to get 2 recycling actions on their board. And with those 2, they're going to grab this one and this one right here. Then finally, they'll take this energy, go over here, spend 2 money. They're going to gain 1 more recycle action, and I think they'll just go up to the top, just make things nice and even, and then they get 1 more science from the bank. And with that, they are done. It's our turn once again, and we currently have 1 worker and 1 energy available. We also only have 1 achievement, and I think this is probably a good time for us to generate and finally grab another achievement, because again, you need to have at least 2 of energy or workers or some combination of. So we are going to do a generation. We've got these 2, which essentially get consumed, and we get to grab a new achievement. Unfortunately for us, none of these 3 are particularly great for us. 1 point for every oil barrel. Well, we have no oil production at the moment. This one gives us 1 point for every building we have with a red arrow, but right now we only have 2 of those buildings. And finally, this one just gives 1 point for every 2 money. Normally, money is just a tiebreaker. I think of all of these, the easiest would potentially be just to take this one and have a reason to try and get lots of money near the tail end of the game. We could potentially liquidate some resources with the trade action or something like that. Whereas this one's dependent on us taking specific buildings. Let's go ahead and grab this achievement right here. And we immediately refill this. And we see this one gives you 1 point for each unpopulated forest you have at the end of the game. With this, we are definitely incentivized to get a money-making engine going even more so than before with this United Nations thing. So we'll definitely try to focus on that in the next round. So now we can gather up all of our workers. Then we discard all of our very plentiful energy. We have no oil barrels to get rid of for petroleum dice. So let's just go ahead and roll these 3 dice. And we get pretty lucky, actually, with that 6 over the 5. That's 6 energy, so pretty good for us. But more importantly, we don't take a contamination, which is always a good thing. So here's our energy. And of course, we have to discard a pollution. There's now just 1 more in the 4th stack. We now come back to blue, and they really want to clear this pollution out, especially considering we're about to do another global impact scoring, and they're not sure which one of these it is, but it seems like a pretty good time for them. They're going to take 1 of their workers and 1 of their energy so that they can go to the cleanup spot as well. They were a bit bummed that Green decided to go there right before they did, and they only have 1 science. They're going to go ahead and spend that, and it'll get them 2 recycle actions. With their first recycle, they will clear up the air so that the resort is even more lucrative for them. With their second, they'll get this one off just to kind of balance things out. And now they're going to take this worker and activate the work core. They obviously cannot recruit anyone else. They're fully recruited and they have no money, but they do get 1 more recycle. And they're going to go ahead and take care of this. It does not make sense for them to flip over this nuclear because it would just become a regular at this point. And we're now in the red global impacts. And I know from experience that some of them force you to flip regular pollution back into nuclear. So that would just be really bad. They're going to clear this one off because they saw that achievement come up, which gives you points for having a cleared forest row, and they figure they might be the ones to get it, so they can work towards that at this point. But unfortunately for blue, the green player now decides they are going to generate, even though they have these 2 energy and a worker left over. That's more than enough for them to grab an achievement. And green decides that they really like the look of this healthy forest achievement. Let's bring out the next one. This gives points for, just having science tokens at the end of the game. The green player currently has 4 open forests, but it's important to note that they actually have an oil well here, so it's impossible for them to clear this spot, so this is going to be a maximum of 4 out of the 5 potential victory points for them, but they still feel pretty good about that. They now collect all of their workers, they discard all this energy, and they decide, I think it's still worth it for them, they are going to get rid of this oil barrel in order to get a petroleum die. This means that the odds are not necessarily in their favor to not take more pollution, and yep, that does not work out too well for them. Wow, that's actually a really big bummer. They rolled a 1 on the blue die. That's terrible. So they only get 5 energy, and they do have to take 1 regular pollution. But I think it was definitely a good idea for them to use that petroleum die, or else they would have only had 3 energy going into the next round instead of these 5, which would be really bad at this point in the game. The last thing they have to do is to take the contamination from the stack, and this is the last one, so we're going to evaluate a global impact once green is done here. And they are certainly not going to put it on the forest. I think they're just going to put it up into the clouds. So let's flip this first red one, although we actually know what this is already because we peaked. We know that it is a diplomatic crisis. It's going to score on forests. We're going to recycle the government buildings, and until we get through this next stack and flip over another global impact, we're going to have to spend an additional energy every single time we try to go into a spot that already has workers in it. First things first, let's reset the government buildings. It seems like this one's been reset much more than the others. We have a national resources. That's pretty simple. Get a recycling or an oil. We've got another environmental agency. The green players use this one pretty well. And lastly, we have a university, which is another way to recruit people, and instead of recycling like the work core, this one just gives 2 money as the alternate. It's worth noting that none of these 3 buildings have contamination in the top, so I think it's somewhat incentivized to go after these buildings for everybody. We now score forests and see that we're going to get 5 points, and then both the blue and green player are going to get 4 points. So we go up to 22, and then green was at 13, so they go to 17, and blue is now at 15. So it's our turn, and I think we're going to go to the industry market, because right now we have 2 steel and 1 science, and that's it. So I think we should spend 1 of our 2 steel in order to grab this modernized factory. It's pretty nice because we can build a steel or a plastic with the use of just 1 person down here. It's worth 4 points, but it is going to force us to put a pollution down in our forests, but we care about that a little less now that we have scored that area that we knew was going to happen with a global impact. So the small plastics factory slides over, and now we have a hazmat team. Oh, this is pretty simple, just spend 2 things in order to get 1 recycling. It's a little expensive, but it does not have any contamination in the top. Just a way to continue to recycle as you're doing industrial things, which appears to be a pretty rare icon in the industry set. We can nestle this in nicely next to the supply chain. We have to take a contamination and put it down into the forest, so we may as well go all the way to the left. And now we can activate both of these. I think that we may as well use energy for both of them, so we'll do that to spend this steel and turn it into 2 plastics. And next up, we can spend 1 energy over here, and I think let's go ahead and grab a steel. Plastic is good for us to have around, but at this point in the game, having 2 plastic would let us buy anything in that current market, so I think we're pretty happy to diversify the types of resources we've got in front of us. We unfortunately don't have any money, so we're not able to do the United Nations just yet, but I think we'll be able to hit that on pretty much every single round for the rest of the game, based on how we try to do these commerce cards to get our money. For Blue's turn, they're going to put a single worker down onto this finance spot, and they don't want to give us money. They're okay with just taking 2 bucks for now. And now they'll spend both of these 2 energy over in their resort, which gets them 1 money for each unpolluted air. Well, they're now up to 5, so that's 5 more money. They have $7, and they feel pretty good about that turn. It's now the green player's turn, and they've decided they want to grab this national resources from the government market. They're going to spend 1 of their 2 science in order to grab this, and it's a pretty simple one with recycling or cans of oil. And then we slide our buildings down, and we see the next one is a healthcare system. That's 2 people for 2 bucks and some science. That seems pretty nice. National Resources does not have any contamination, which is really quite nice for them. And now they are going to put 1 of their energy down here, spend 2 money. They're going to gain a science for doing this, and they're going to do a recycle action. And I think they're going to go ahead and remove this one from the air. And I think they want to stay ahead of the contamination curve, so they'll go here, and they'll go ahead and remove 1 more of these air. It's our turn once again, and I think it makes sense for us to go and pick up something from the commerce market. We just picked up the 2 plastic on our last turn, and we'd really like to make some money so that we can bump the United Nations. With that 2 plastic, we can actually buy any of these different buildings, and I think there's an argument to be said about all of them. The first one is really cheap, it doesn't have any contamination, and it will allow us to keep making plastic, and at the end of the game we get 1 point for up to 5 plastic in our area. However, we need money to do a whole bunch of things, including our United Nations, and we get points for that at the end of the game. So both of these makes points and it generates a victory point. This costs an extra energy or a person, but makes 1 extra money for doing that. This one, I think I'm tempted towards more, but it costs a second plastic, so I really have to think back and forth which of these is more important. And I think at the end of the day, being flexible is more important. So we're going to go ahead and grab this one, spending both of our plastic, because it means we could just spend 1 energy or 1 person in order to get our benefit, making it more possible to potentially do a generation turn and grab some more of the achievements down there instead of having it clogged up by just gaining 1 extra money. Well, we're going to get some money anyway. And now we get to see the next building. It is a port. You can spend $1 to get oil, steel, plastic, or science. It's a very flexible one. So let's put this mass transit down here, and we do have to put a pollution down onto our land area, so we'll slide that over there. And now we can activate both of these, and I think we may as well do both. We'll use energy for each one, so we'll go here, get 3 money, and here, and get a 4th money, and a victory point, but we do give 1 money to both of our opponents. That 1 point brings us up to 23. And what the heck, let's do the United Nations as well, so we'll spend our 1 science and 2 of the 4 money in order to bump that track. And I think for the first time in the game, we are not farthest on this track behind, or tied for that anyway. It's the blue player's turn, and even though they have one worker left, they would not have anything to potentially boost. All their buildings are maxed out with these energy and workers already, and it's really important to them to stay in the lead on this United Nations track, and right now they're tied for us, so they really want to make sure to generate before us to potentially get to the end of that track earlier. So they are going to generate. They don't get to get any of the achievements because they only have one person, so they can pull all of their tons and tons of workers back to the board. All of their energy is going to get cleared off. And they're going to go ahead and roll only two dice, and they get relatively lucky here. So the six is the high one. They get five energy for two dice. That's really quite good. Although they are definitely feeling like they should do something about increasing the amount of energy they make, especially because, well, everybody knows they took an achievement that has something to do with energy because that was a public thing. So that's probably going to be one of their short-term goals here. And lastly, we are going to discard the top contamination from the stack. It doesn't go onto the board because they rolled much better with that blue die. There are only two tokens left in the stack. It's Green's turn, and they decide to evaluate the trade location in the commerce area. And the only trade they want to do is to get rid of these two money in order to buy themselves a steal. The biggest reason they went into that spot is to allow themselves to activate all of these commerce buildings they have. So the first thing they'll do is put an energy up here on the bank that's going to generate them two money. And if you don't mind, I am actually going to slightly undo how they did this previous turn. I was not thinking too far ahead with this player, and they absolutely would have done this if they were just paying close attention. Instead of taking this recycling action, they absolutely should have taken the barrel of oil. So I'm just going to do a little retcon back and bring this barrel of oil here, and I am almost positive that there was a pollution up here when they pulled back. So I'm going to put that back up there because this sets them up over here so that they can spend this energy here to consume this barrel of oil and get two money and a victory point. So this brings them to four money and 18 points. Next up, they'll send a worker over to the import company. They'll spend one money, and this gives them the barrel of oil and plastic that they need to send this worker over to the United Nations spot to consume both of these and go once up on the track. Well, we can almost see it on the screen here. I'll just go ahead and bump it right there. We are all now tied in this position here. So it's now back to us, and we have one worker and two energy. And we could generate right now and get another achievement, but that would be kind of a waste because we have three things, and in order to grab an achievement, we only need two of these remaining. I think what kind of makes sense is we need to up our energy production. We've got enough workers, and we've been using these three dice for a very long time, but at this point, our board does not have that much pollution on it. I suppose let's go ahead and send our worker over to the power plant. We're going to spend the one steel that we have, and this is going to generate one coal die for us. This is worth 2 points, which is nice, and it means next turn, when we are going to be forced to generate, we can roll all four of these dice and have even more energy for the next phase, because we were not able to really utilize all of our buildings. In fact, we never even made it to the government section, and these are really good buildings for us to activate, so I'd love to get just tons and tons of energy to maybe hit all of these in the next wave before we generate again. It's the blue player's turn, and they really want to build a building, but there's somebody in all three of these spots already, and because of this global impact card, it would cost 2 energy in order to go onto one of those spots, and they did not get as much energy as they wanted to in the last generate phase. Also, they can tell that both of us, their opponents anyway, are going to be generating on their next turn, so blue is essentially stalling here, and they've decided they're going to go over here, and they're going to buy 3 barrels of oil, and they can see that the cost for that is the current stack, which is 4 money. So they're going to spend the $4 to get the 3 barrels of oil, and now they're going to spend one of their people and one of their energy to go over and activate this resort. It'll get them 5 money because they have 5 unpolluted spots in their area, and with that, they are done with their turn. They don't want to activate the United Nations just yet. We're now back to the green player, and they've decided they have a worker and an energy left. They are feeling pretty good about stopping and doing a generation, so they get to grab a new achievement first because they have these two here. They are very happy to grab this scientific leader one, which will get them 1 point for every science symbol. They have 2 at the moment, although they of course might spend them, but they're feeling pretty good about their ability to grab more of them. And we now get to see a new one. This is clean air, 1 victory point per unpolluted airspace in the environment. Wow, the blue player would really love this one. Green now gets back all of their workers into their area, and they get to discard all of this energy here. And unfortunately for them, they don't have any oil anymore, so they're just rolling these two dice, and they're hoping to get lucky here. And, well, that's probably about as good as you can expect from these two. In fact, looking over here, that is the best thing they could get. Because they're tied, they get to choose this one, so they're not going to take contamination, and they get 4 energy from them, so they're feeling pretty good about that. We now discard the top pollution marker here, and we see there's only 1 left over until we go into the 5th global impact card. And in fact, that is destined to happen at the end of our turn because we must generate. We have no workers. We do have these two here, so we can grab a new achievement. And we are pretty bummed that the green player took that scientific one because we are in a pretty good position to make a bunch of science tokens. So looking at these three, well, right here, this gives you 1 point for each red arrow on the buildings that you have. We've got 7 buildings, but only 2 of them have the red arrow. This gives points for oil. We have 0 oil. And then this over here, clean air, we have 3 open spots, although 2 of our contamination, one of them is nuclear, so it'll be hard to clear it. But right from the get-go, this is worth 3 points, this is worth 2, and this is worth 0. I think we want to work off of this one and maybe try to clean up our air and get some more points for it at the end of the game. Let's now draw a new one, and this is diversified. You get 1 point per each resource type held. Oh, wow, so just having a wide variety of stuff at the end of the game could give you some good points. So there is our third achievement. We can now pull back all of our workers from the board. We still only have 4 of them. Let's discard all this energy, and I think we're about to make a whole bunch because we're now rolling all 4 of these dice here. So let's see what we get. That is unlucky for us. Wow, actually quite unlucky. So first of all, we're going to get a nuclear symbol, and then even though we have 4 dice, we get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Well, 7 energy is still good, although as you can see, we missed the opportunity to potentially get, I think, up to 10. Well, I guess the black die can only go up to 2. So I'm over-harping on it. This is a reasonably good roll because the green dice never does a lot for us. We're mostly just bummed about having to put some nuclear contamination down. Oops, I forgot to discard this energy here. So there is the 7 we get to play with. Let's take the last token from that stack. We flip it over to the nuclear side, and I guess we'll put it down in the water to even things out. Our turn is now over, so we get to evaluate the next global impact card. This one goes away. Nobody ended up actually spending that penalty, but it definitely affected the actions that the players took. They dodged going on to spots that other people were at because it made it more expensive. And let's flip this over. Nobody knows what it has on it, and it is a chemical spill. Okay, so that gives points for the air, so the blue player is quite happy. We're going to recycle the industrial buildings, but down here it says, each player takes 2 pollution tokens from the supply. They choose 1 row of their environment with sufficient space, and they put both of the tokens in that row. That's really nasty. It doesn't have an ongoing effect, but this one is not great at all. First of all, we score points for the air. We're going to get 3 points. Blue is going to get 5, and green will get 4. So we go to 26. Green goes 1, 2, 3, 4 up to 22. And lastly, blue jumps up to 20. Let's now recycle all of these industrial buildings and see what new stuff we have in store. We have a steel mill, that's pretty simple. We've got a super tanker, oh that's cool, get a barrel of oil and some money. And lastly, we have an iron mine. Nope, that's just another way to get lots of steel. See, this one, remember, you have to do this on multiple industrial area activations, but this one, you can just spend 2 and get the 2 immediately. It's now time to evaluate the chemical spills. It goes in player order. I'm not exactly sure if I'm the active player or not, so I'll just start with me, and let's put both of them down into the water just to kind of keep things as even as possible, although not too great for us. We want to start cleaning this stuff up. The blue player has to put these 2 down. They're certainly not going into the air. I think they'll go ahead and go down here so as not to go too far out on the water area. And finally, the green player, I think when they consider both of these different options, they're going to go ahead and put it down into the land area. Oh wait, no, they have an achievement. They'll put it down into water. Now that the power plant has been cleared, the blue player is going to jump in there, and they've decided they want to buy a coal die of their own, so they'll spend 1 steel to do that. And next, they will put an energy into their small steel mill to make 1 steel for themselves, and then probably a person and an energy into their uranium mine to make themselves another steel and a science token. And lastly, I think they're going to go ahead, let's see, energy or workers. I think they'll put a worker into this spot here. They'll spend 2 money and 1 of the steel in order to bump up on the United Nations track. So they go from 12 points to 15, and it's worth noting that there's a bit of diminishing returns going on here. The first jump and the second and third are all worth 4 points, but this was only worth 3 points, and the next one is only worth 2. But the reason this is good is because it keeps you in the lead, and the person who is in the lead is going to get 3 points at the end of the game, and it positions blue to potentially go here where nobody else can even jockey for that position, and they would lock in that 3 points. Essentially, this is a 20-point spot, so that's what they're shooting for. It's now the green player's turn, and they're going to go to the government market, and they've decided to pick up this university. Even though they have an achievement to have science tokens at the end of the game, it still is worth it for them to spend the science token in order to pick up this building right here. The healthcare system slides over, and now we see that there is a science lab here. They add that into their other government buildings, and they've decided to activate all of these. So they'll go here, and they will grab an oil barrel. They're not going to make the same mistake I did last time. We'll put a worker over here onto the environmental agency. They'll spend 2 money. This is going to get them the science back that they just spent, and they also get to recycle 1 thing from the environment. They're going to go ahead and grab this pollution away here, and then they will put this energy over here onto the university, and they will just go ahead and take 2 money. And with that, their turn is over. It's our turn once again, and even though we have so many buildings, I think let's go ahead and get another one, although we will need another energy to power along. Let's grab ourselves another environmental agency. This one's just really nice. It lets us spend a little bit of money in order to get some recycling and these science things. Also has no contamination, and it's straight up worth 3 points. So I feel pretty good about grabbing this card. We can slide both of these down and see that the new card is a nuclear reactor, so definitely a good way to get a bunch of science right away. The green player might be interested in this one. We can slide this next to our other 3 government agencies, and then I think we want to just activate all of these. We can go ahead and start. We'll throw an energy down over here. We'll spend both of our money in order to get a science symbol, which is nice because we're currently out of everything, and then we'll also get a recycling symbol, and let's see, I don't think we have any specific goals here. Oh no, we do, the clean air. We want to clear that out, so we'll remove this, which gives us a point at the end of the game. Next up, let's throw 2 energy down into this nuclear agency. That'll get us a steel and another science symbol. Now let's throw an energy over onto the work core, and let's do the recycle action. Obviously, we can't afford to get another worker, although more workers would be nice. It's interesting to note, I just counted it out. We appear to be doing great by getting all this energy from this dice, but when I added up the number of workers and energy I had, it was the same amount that the blue player had in their last generation, even though they rolled so poorly with so few dice. Well, they just have so many workers that it both compensated out to 11, which is kind of interesting. Anyway, so we get to do 1 recycle action. We could flip this over and then hopefully clear it out later because of our achievement, but I think it makes more sense just to get rid of this for now because, well, it's 1 point for the spot and another point for the column. And lastly, it's a guaranteed point because this could end up getting flipped back, or we might just never get around to actually removing it. Next, let's go ahead and throw a worker onto the lunar lander, and we will take 1 victory point. We've got a couple science, we're pretty happy with that. Which brings us to 27. We don't have the money in order to activate our United Nations, and we're starting to wonder how much worth it is to us because it is now only 3 points instead of 4. It's likely we'll end up hitting this one again, but at this point, it seems relatively a sure thing that the blue player is going to win that overall race. It's the blue player's turn, and even though they have 3 things available to them with 2 energy and the worker, they've decided they are going to generate, so they'll go ahead and grab their 3rd achievement. And they like the look of this diversified one. They already have 1 of everything except for the plastic, and they figure they could probably figure out a way to grab that before the game ends. The game is getting close to ending, but there are still 6 of those contamination tokens. Well, there'll be 5 after this generation. And of course, let's get a new achievement. This is Global Influence, 1 victory point per space you moved on the United Nations track. Ooh, this is really good for the blue player. Now they recall all of their 6 workers back to home base, and they get to discard all of their excess energy, and now they do have some of this oil. They're going to go ahead and, let's see, do they go crazy? I think they'll spend 1 oil so that they roll 4 dice, and you know what? Actually, they want to do a lot of stuff. They'll spend 2 oil. They're going to roll all 5 of these dice here. It's almost guaranteed that they're going to have to put down some contamination. They're just really hoping it's not nuclear. And lucky for them, it looks like they are not going to take nuclear contamination. A couple poor rolls over here, so they get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 energy. That's 1 away from the overall max. They now have to put some regular contamination down into their environment, and they're just going to go ahead and even it out a little bit, but keeping the airspace open. Even though they have lots of money, they figure they may as well keep this resort in a pretty good situation to keep spewing out the money by clearing this airspace. They've already broken this 1 spot, may as well put 2, and maybe they'll be able to kill both of these at the same time later on by ditching a sign symbol. It's the green player's turn, and they're going to go to the commerce market and pick up this warehouse. They'll spend 2 of their $3 to do it, and they don't have to take any contamination for this card. We'll now slide these down and see the new building is a highway. It lets you spend oil to get steel or plastic, and a victory point. So they add this in with the rest of their commerce buildings, and now they are going to do some activating. They'll throw 1 over here on the bank, and that's going to get them the 2 money they just spent right back. And now they are going to go over here. They're going to spend this oil barrel in order to get 2 money and a victory point, which brings them to 5 bucks and 23 points. They've got 2 workers left, and they figure they'll use both of them. So they'll go here. They'll spend one money that gets them a plastic and a barrel of oil, and the last worker will go to the United Nations, spending the oil and the plastic to bump once on the track. This ties them with the blue player, gaining them 3 points, and it all but assures that the blue player will move up to this last position on their final turn to make sure they secure in that leader bonus. It's back to our turn, and we have two workers and two energy. We have a few different options, but I'm not really sure what the right thing to do is. We could go and get an industrial building. We could spend this one steel to do that. The ones that we could buy are worth 3 points, but they also both come with a contamination, so they're sort of worth only 2 points each. We also have like no money right now, so potentially we could go and activate a commerce spot and get some money by piggybacking on these buildings and maybe even activate this United Nations spot. We know for sure we're not going to win the race to get to the very end, but it is worth 3 points, and that seems relatively good. In fact, I think let's go ahead and do that. So we'll spend one of our workers, we'll plunk them down into finance and just take $2 for ourselves. Next up, let's spend an energy on mass transit because victory points are nice, so we'll go ahead and take one of those. And now we have 28 points. And lastly, we decide whether or not we are going to activate the United Nations. If we don't and generate on the next turn, then we would be able to grab one of the available achievements. But right now, the achievements are worth 3 points for two of them and 0 points for the other. So it's 3 points potentially scaling up, or we could just go to the United Nations, spend the two money and the science, and take the 3 guaranteed points. But, you know, this costs resources, and resources are nice to do other things. Let's go ahead and hold off, actually, not activate the United Nations and take one of the at least 3 victory point achievements on the next go-around, and those could potentially get even better before the game ends. It's now the blue player's turn. With their army of workers and incredible amount of energy, they're only going to take one worker and put them out on the board. They've decided to buy this super tanker here by spending this one steel. They are going to have to put a contamination down into their water, but it's a way to make oil and some money. That gets added in with their other industrial buildings, and they put this contamination down into their water. Definitely very polluted waters in the land of blue over here. And now they're going to take 2 energy, they're going to activate this super tanker here. That's going to get them 1 barrel of oil, bringing them back to 2, and it's going to give them $2, so they continue to have lots and lots of money in front of them. And they figure they will go ahead and spend this 2 energy activating their uranium mine, which gives them another steel from the supply and 1 science token. And they don't think that it's worth activating the small steel at this point. Well, actually, now that I think about it, they will do that with one of their workers because they can then go over here, spending that steel immediately and the $2 in order to do the final bump on the United Nations track. And that leaves them with 1 steel remaining. It's always nice to have at least one of these types of things hanging around to potentially grab a building or something like that. With this, they have locked in the United Nations track. Nobody else can go to the 17 point, so that is a guaranteed 20 points that they have. And I forgot to mention that this building slides over and we get a new one. This is a steel mill, just like this one right here. May as well go for this one, it's a lot cheaper. It's the green player's turn, they are completely out of everything, so they will regenerate, pulling all of their people back to their area and discarding all of this energy. They once again only roll 2 dice. They definitely need to probably get some more dice, although the game is getting close to ending, so the relative benefit of having dice is getting lower. They'll roll these, and that's pretty darn good. They once again get the best energy outcome, and they don't take a contamination, so they are pretty happy with that result. The 4 energy comes back into their area. And lastly, we discard the top pollution from the track. There are only 2 pollution left, so the game is getting very close to being over. Once the final pollution is taken from the track, then everybody is going to get 1 more turn, including the player whose action took the final pollution from that track. And that is certainly happening soon, because we are going to be generating now with these two here, which means we get to take our 4th achievement. Again, you can have up to 5 achievements, and each one can get up to 5 victory points. It's a nice, easy way to remember that. From the 3 available achievements, we are thinking about these two. This one gives points for each arrow we have in our buildings, and right now we have 3 of those. And this one gives 1 point for each bump up on the United Nations track you've done. Well, this is a guaranteed 3 points, and this is already 3 points for the 3 buildings we have. When we look out at the board, we see there are only 2 out here that actually have the red arrow. So I think the easier thing is to bump up on the United Nations track again. So let's go ahead and grab this, and it'll incentivize us to do this last bump because it'll be worth 1 more point to us. Let's go ahead and fill this spot in. That's going to be the Titan of Industry, 1 point per industrial structure. Currently, the blue player has 3, so they'd be the most interested in this one. So let's add this to the top of the stack and pull back all of our workers. We only have 4, and discard all of this energy and get ready to roll the dice. We have two happy dice in here and two sad dice. We just really don't want to get nuclear pollution. And it looks like we are okay on the... Actually, no, this is great. We pulled a 6 on the green die. Oh, this is perfect. So we get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 energy, which is huge. And with this 6 right here, that means we don't have to take any contamination. So we go ahead and discard the second to last pollution token from the track. It's the blue player's turn, and they've decided to go and grab a government building. In fact, they're going to get this science lab. It's going to cost them this one science token here, but not take any contamination, which is pretty good for them. We can scroll this down and see that the new building is another national resources. They slide this up here, but they decide they don't actually want to activate it. It doesn't matter that much to them, but they will go ahead and throw one of their workers over onto the work core in order to get this recycling action so that they can get rid of this, because it's actually a 3-point move, because this frees up this column to give them 2 points at the end of the game if that's the way it actually ends up. We have no idea what the last global impact is actually going to do, but they're setting themselves up for that. The green player decides they also want to buy a government building, so they'll spend an energy to go here as well, and they're going to grab this healthcare system, but they're going to spend 2 money to grab it instead of the science. We can slide these down and see the next building is legislature. Ooh, I don't think we've seen this one before. You put 1 money from the supply, oh, from your own supply, onto any board location and gain a victory point, and then whenever anybody goes to that spot, they would get the money back. That's a very interesting building. It's a pity we are only seeing it now. I would have enjoyed playing with that one. So they slide the healthcare system in here, they take the final contamination from the board, so the endgame is essentially triggered at the end of this turn, and they have to put this down in the water, which is not great for them. And now, with all of the stuff they have available to them, they have decided they are going to put, let's see, they're going to put this one over here, that's going to spend 2 money, but it's going to gain them a science, bringing them up to 3, and they will immediately recycle away this one contamination they just got. They're going to spend a worker and an energy to activate the healthcare system they just grabbed in order to get a 4th science symbol, and they'll get 2 more money. And since they know that theirs will be the final turn of the game, they don't really need 2 workers lying around, they'll go ahead and throw this one over here, and with this little going on over here, they decide not to take the barrel, they're going to take the recycling, and they'll clear this water spot up there. I don't think I've mentioned yet, but at the end of the game, when you score these columns, you also score your entire environment again, in addition to the global impact that is about to happen, well, right now. This is the final one for the game, and it is a nuclear disaster. It's going to hit water zones, we'll recycle the industrial bit, and we see down here that each player chooses 3 pollution tokens in their own environment. You flip them over to become nuclear contamination tokens. So at this point in the game, it doesn't matter that much, but earlier in the game, it could really be a problem. It makes it much harder to get rid of the contamination we already have. First, let's score the oceans. The green player is very happy they happened to clear that up. They went back and forth on several different options, but that worked out for them. So we're going to get 3 points. The blue player is only going to get 2 points, and the green player is going to get 4. So we go to 31. The blue player is going to go to 22, and green goes to 27. Next, we recycle all of these industrial buildings. We see 3 more. We have a computer factory, a uranium mine, and lastly, an oil pipeline. And now, in turn order, we each have to flip over up to 3 contamination to nuclear, so the green player only has 2, they'll flip both of those. We have 3, so we'll flip all of these. That's not going to be doing much cleaning on our last turn, I don't think. Well, we'll see what our options are like. And finally, the blue player, they're going to go ahead and flip this one, and let's see, I'm not sure how much they care, so they'll just go ahead and flip this land one. It's now our final turn, and let's take a look at our achievements. We have 4 of them. The first one, the Synthetic Pioneer, 1 point for each plastic cube. Well, we're not doing a very good job of that. We have 0 plastic cubes right now, so maybe we want to get some plastic this turn. This Wealth gives us 1 point for every 2 money. Well, we only have 3 money, so not that great on this one. Clean Air is pretty good. That's 4 points, and I'm not sure if it's worth it to try and clear this nuclear contamination. And lastly, the Global Influence. We currently have 3 points on this, but if we potentially could push forward, that would give us a bonus point. But in order to move up on the United Nations, we have to spend 2 money, and 2 money is worth a buck to us. So, I don't know, they kind of are mutually exclusive in that respect. And after looking at all of our options, I think we want to go ahead and buy another industrial building and try to squeeze out a couple of these plastics, and it does, I think, make sense to hit the United Nations up. It's a 3-point bonus. Sure, we're going to lose a point for the money that we'd lose, but we'd gain the point right back for the other achievement. So we send our worker over to the industrial market, and we're going to grab this computer factory, even though we have no intention of actually running it because we actually want plastic. We're going to spend this deal in order to grab this factory. It's nice that it has no contamination. And we can slide these over and see this is another oil pipeline. We can nestle this computer factory in right here, and you'll notice that by spending that one steel, I've denied myself 2 points potentially in the this conversion rate, but actually what we'll do is just throw an energy up here, and we're gonna take a steel back for it, and then consume that steel over here to get ourselves 2 plastic. So if we had saved that steel and spent the money, we would have had 1 more plastic in our area, but then we would not have had enough money to activate our United Nations. So let's go ahead and throw the energy down there, spend a science and this 2 money in order to get the 1 tick there, which ties us at 15 with the green player, and we couldn't have gone farther anyway because blue player got here first. For the blue player's final action, they're gonna go to the commerce market. They're gonna spend $4 in order to grab this highway here, and we can bring out probably the last commerce car of the game. It's another airport. The highway comes with 1 air contamination, so we'll just pull that from the supply and put it over there. We can put this up here, and they're gonna spend their last worker to go here, cash in this 1 oil barrel there, in order to get a plastic and 1 victory point. And this brings them to 23. And we've reached the final turn of the game for the green player. They've looked around, they've crunched the numbers, and they've decided the best possible way, the most points they could possibly get, is to generate now. So they are gonna do that. They have these 3 things here which allow them to grab an achievement. They're gonna take this one because it's currently worth 4 points, and they are hoping that when they generate, this blue die will be higher than the black die, or at least the same, because if that's not the case, then they will lose a point in the process. So this goes right there. We can go ahead and bring everybody back into the green player's starting area. We discard all of this energy, and let's see if the green player got lucky. And they did! They did! 4-3, so they are going to get 4 energy, which they don't really care about. Most importantly, they don't put a contamination down. That was a 4-point turn for them. With that, the game is now over, and let's jump into the final scoring. The first thing is each player is going to get victory points for all of the buildings that they've acquired. When we add mine up, it's an even 30 points, which brings us up to 61. Blue has 24 points, which brings them to 47. And green has 27, which brings them to 54. Now we get points for our energy dice. We have 4 of them, so that's going to be 8 more points for us, bringing us from 61 up to 69. The blue player has 3, so they'll get 6 points. They go from 47 to 53, and the green player only has 2, so they're gonna get 4 points for that. They go from 54 up to 58. Next up, let's look at achievements. So our first one here is plastic, so we're gonna get 2 points for that. Next up, we have wealth. Well, we're gonna get 0 points for that. That one really whiffed for us. We have clean air, that's gonna get us 4 points. And lastly, we have the United Nations track. We bumped up 4 times, so that's 4 more points there. That's a grand total of 10 points, so we go from 69 to 79. The green player only has 3 achievements. The first one that they started with is strong workforce. They get 1 victory point per worker, -1. This is part of the reason they went so hard to get all those workers. So that's gonna be 5 points because they have all their workers. Next up, they get 1 point for every energy they have. Well, that's 4, so that's 4 more. They bring them to 9. And lastly, diversified, they get 1 point for each item in this trough in the bottom. They got all of those, so that's 5 more points, bringing this to 14 total. And that jumps them up to 67. And now the green player has 4 achievements. The one they started with was cultural heritage, 1 point for every green building, so that's 4 points there. Then healthy forests, they're gonna get 4 points for that one. The scientific leader, they're gonna get 4 points for that. And finally, the arrows, they've got 1, 2, 3, 4, well, 4 points for all 4 of these. That's 16 points, which jumps them up to 74. Next up, let's do the United Nations track. Green and red, we were both able to get 15, and blue is gonna get 20, because that's 17 plus 3. So we go to 94, green goes to 89, and blue jumps to 87. And lastly, we're gonna score our environments. We were able to keep all 3 of these columns clear, so that's 6 points there, and then we also have a bunch of spots over here, so that's 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16 total. And that gives us a final score of 110. Let's see if it's enough to keep the lead. Unfortunately, blue did not fare quite as well over here. They only get these 2 column bonuses, which is 5, and then 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. And that gives them a final score of 100 exactly. And finally, we have green. They were able to get the 6 points for the column bonuses, and then that's 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. This brings them up to 107, and there are the final scores. We were able to win it with 110. It was surprisingly close here. Blue tagged behind a little bit, but you know, 10-point difference in a over 100-point scoring game does not seem too bad to me. I hope you enjoyed this playthrough. I'd like to apologize briefly again about the poor audio quality for the first 40 minutes of the playthrough. I'm not exactly sure what happened, and I did the best I could to make the audio as good as possible for you guys to listen to. When it comes to the actual game, I think it was a pretty good showing of how the different mechanics work. I will say that I played this game a couple times with actual other opponents, and we have made more energy dice in those games versus this playthrough. It's interesting to see one of the players, Green, end the game with just two dice and still only lose by 3 points to us, who had four dice at the end of the game, although I play games with other people where several people max out all of their dice. It's an interesting difference between the energy that you get from the dice you roll and just the workers that you can hire throughout the game. They do very similar things, but in a couple ways they are different. But when you're doing one or the other, I think it's kind of okay as long as you're not neglecting both of acquiring more workers and getting more energy dice. I thought it was pretty cool the way that the green player completely neglected the industry aspect of the board entirely. As the red player, we kind of did a bit of everything with all three of the different tracks, and the green player pretty much only went to the industry spot, I think, twice in the game to pick up the two dice that they had, and they did a whole bunch of other things, having a really good engine going over there with the commerce section, and yeah, they lost by only 3 points, so that's a very close type of situation with the game. It did seem also that there were some rather lucky dice rolls going on, especially with the contamination going out onto the boards. It doesn't affect the game clock because you discard those tokens, but there were many times where I feel like it could have shifted slightly in the other way, especially for us, considering at the very beginning of the game, we had that yellow nuclear die, and I think we only ended up taking one contamination throughout the whole game. We, of course, played around mitigating that by getting the blue and the green die so that it was less likely that that one would be high, but I think we maybe got a little more lucky with that specific die roll than we otherwise could have, and that could have changed the way the game goes. I mean, 3 points is not a lot, but at the end of the game, when each of the players was trying to crunch how they're going to squeeze the most possible points they could on their last turns, in general, it seemed like, you know, even 1 or 2 point difference between a couple actions was a big deal. So I think it was a rather solid win for us. I don't think it went to the whims of the dice, but that is definitely a thing that is going to affect how you're going to be playing this game each time you sit down to the table. I don't really have anything else to say about it. I enjoyed this playthrough of it. I usually enjoy filming these playthroughs, but this one in particular, I've enjoyed making the different types of engines and seeing how they were going to pan out, and I'm glad that it came so close at the end. I was pretty worried that the blue player was going to be way down at the end. I mean, of course, they came in last, but only a 10-point difference between the first and last place player in a 110-point scoring winning game. I am totally okay with that. So let's go ahead and wrap this up. I'd like to thank everyone who has been supporting the channel through Patreon, including all of these producer-level pledges. If you too would like to directly support the channel, you could do so at patreon.com/JohnGetsGames, and I'd super appreciate it. Also, if you'd like to see more full game playthroughs like this one, as well as in-depth board game reviews and vlogs that I do at least once a month, please subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching.